welcome to East Rockingham High School at our sixth winter concert. It's incredible to say sixth. It feels like yesterday that we opened this school. And I'm almost hesitant to say that it's the winter concert because the temperatures have been so spring-like out there. But we would like to thank you for coming today and supporting the good work of our students. Our members are continuing to grow in choir, and not just because of what's happening inside these walls. Your support and attendance and donations and word-of-mouth advertising in our community demonstrates your endorsement of choral music and the fine arts in Elkton. As you enter today, you probably noticed a donation box in the back and the opportunity to buy for a raffle ticket for a music-themed basket. What a great gift this would make for someone. And your generosity helps us to continue to create opportunities for these students to further their musical experiences and their cultural experiences. I've been thinking back today about 6 years ago. Today, as we listen to these singers, think back 6 years to who you were and how old you were 6 years ago and what you were doing. And think to where you are right now and what you're doing, and then look ahead to 6 years and think about what you might become. This is why we're doing what we do, to help you become the people that we know you can be. And it's really exciting for us to see that. Mr. Hersler, would you raise the lights just a little bit, because I want to do something right now. I have had some of these students for the entire time that we've had this school open. And so I want to like a show of hands from you ladies up here. But then if you would stand when I say, if you have been in choir all 6 years, whether that's at Elkton Middle School or at East Rockingham High School, would you stand up if you've been in for all 6 years so far? Yep. Okay. And raise your hands up here. Okay. 5 years. Stand up or raise your hand. 4 years. In Elkton or at East Rock. Big hand. It's good. You should be proud of that. 3 years. 2 years. 1 year. And that should be everybody. Scarlett, you're 1 year. Very good. Okay, you may sit down. Thank you. Isn't that incredible that we have that many kids? The group that is behind me is Red Heels ReCHOIR-ed. And we are going to start off the concert for you this afternoon with a very traditional carol, Here We Come a Caroling, which is also called Here We Come a Wassailing. A wassail is a sung blessing on your household, so that people would travel around from neighbor to neighbor singing Christmas carols and singing wassails. And so this is a traditional wassail. Mr. Hertzler, thank you.
Here we come a caroling, dear
also like to thank my very good friend Karen Holl, who has joined us today as our accompanist. So thank you very much, Karen. Edgar Allan Poe is the lyricist for this next selection. While living in New York, Poe lived in the Bronx near Fordham University, where the bells could be heard from the university church. He wrote a four-verse poem about them as a result. The composer, Lon Beery, of this selection has set only one of the verses. The bells can at times be concordant or discordant, and the composer has tried to capture those qualities in this song, The Bells.
Thank you.
traditional song from the Panay Island in the Philippines with a beautiful violin descant. Ili Ili Tulog Anay translates, "Hush, hush, sleep now. Mother is not here. She went to buy bread." Hush, hush now, sleep. This song would have been sung by an older sibling to a younger baby. The traditional language is Ilonggos, a language common to the region. And we welcome sophomore Helen St. John on violin. The girls that are coming on the stage right now are Varsity Choir, and it is our newest addition to the family of choirs at East Rockingham High School. Students must audition for this group by proving their ability to sight read slash rhythmic read, maintain good tuning, and be eager, self-motivated learners. We meet in the morning before school at 7, and they're always, well, almost always, up, raring, and ready to go. The group is open to males and females, but this year clearly you can see that we have all females. Our first number is called the Apple Tree Wassail, and much like the piece that I explained, our opening piece for Red Heels ReCHOIR-ed, a wassail is a blessing on home and hearth. This particular wassail, Apple Tree, is from the Devonshire area of England, and so we hope that you enjoy our version of Apple Tree Wassail. they're going to perform for you is called Tundra, and it is about the tundra in the Norwegian areas. The poem goes like this. Wide, worn, and weathered, sacred expanse of green and white and granite gray, snowy patches strewn, anchored to the craggy earth, unmoving, while clouds dance across the vast eternal sky. I'm really quite proud of these young women for mastering this next piece. At times, these 10 singers cover six-part harmony, which means that several of the girls cover parts on their own. Quite a fantastic example of part singing independence. Special thanks to our accompanist Karen, because I had a little snafu on this piece, and I'll just admit my mistake now, but she came to my rescue, and so Karen, thank you very much. Rabindranath Tagore, a Bengali poet from the early, from the late 19th century, early 20th century. The poem is, "When I sing to make you dance, I know why there is music in leaves and why waves send their chorus of voices to the heart of the listening earth. When I sing to make you dance, we are free." Musically, the composer has set this simple tune with a complex underlying structure. There are lots of rhythmic contrasts between the song and the pianist and instrumentalist. "When I sing to make you dance." Selection is not a holiday number, but it is a very fun selection with an upbeat pop kind of sound from the 1940s. The Andrews sisters have become iconic for their intensely tight harmonies and effervescent energy. We learned this piece for our Veterans Day ceremony, but we have had such fun with it that we just didn't want to let go of it yet, and we want to share it with you. Enjoy the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Whoa. Just Joe and Levi. We got a couple more, sorry.
How many of you audience members were in your late teens or early 20s in 1984? Me. You two? Do you remember a group called Wham? With George Michael?
Hannah.
Yeah, thanks. This is that blast from the past and has recently been remade by Taylor Swift. Joe and Levi are going to join us for this piece with their vocal percussion, they call it beatboxing, to our version of Last Christmas. And we do have a number of solos and duets in this selection.
Special. Thank you.
Ensemble. This is our longest standing group in East Rock's history. And we're proud, I'm very proud of this group. When we opened East Rockingham High School, we had about 21, 22 kids involved in the program. And now I can proudly say that we have 79 in the program. And that doesn't include the couple of classes of class piano that I have as well. So I teach almost, we have a school of about 650, so you do the math. I'm not good at math. I'm good at music, not math. But anyway, so we're really proud to say that we have grown quite a bit over the course of the years. The opening of the song that you're going to hear is inspired by the Sami people of Scandinavia and Russia. The opening sounds are a series of short, repetitive phrases. They have no specific linguistic meaning, but often have a connection to nature and beauty and God, those types of qualities. The tune presented in the female voices will, however, be recognizable to many of you. This song was used at the beginning of the very popular movie Frozen. And you pronounce the title of this piece, Itnemen Beauty. Sure about the meaning of the lyrics, but we enjoy it anyway. And we just fell in love with the piece and the harmonies and the element of fun that's provided in the hand patterns provided by our 5 students up here. I think you'll be really amazed at their ability to add so much energy to the piece through that. This is White Winter Hymnal.
Gloria, Gloria, in excelsis Gloria.
ask the singers to come up on stage, please. We're going to do two numbers here at the end. The first is called Hine Mato. If you came to our all-county choir concert back in October, you will have heard of about 250 students perform this selection. It is a wonderful piece. It is Hebrew, and it comes from the Bible, Psalm 133. Behold how good and pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in peace. And at this time of the year, when families gather amidst a world that has seen so much violence, so many violent acts, peace seems to be, well, a premium. And it is exactly what we need in our world today. So I look behind me and I see brothers and sisters making peace and music and harmony and unity, and it makes me really happy. This piece is set in a lively style with a fantastic clarinet descant played by Elizabeth Haldane. This is Hine Matov. Just by inherently being part of their family. So
please join us. We have lots of things that we'd like to do and lots of ways that we would like to create opportunities for these kids up here. Aren't they magnificent? Aren't they wonderful? Also, as you noticed, there is a donation box in the back, and also if you neglected to buy a raffle ticket before the concert began, please buy a raffle ticket on your way out. We also would like to offer to you the beautiful poinsettias that are down here. They are offered and grown in our own agricultural department, so they are a courtesy and decoration of our FFA department. They are $5 a piece. And if you would like one of those, a couple of our parents will be down here to collect your money for those. At this time, I would like to invite our alumni up. And while they're getting up here, I have just a couple more things to say. So if there is alumni of the choir out there, please come on up, find your section, and we're going to sing Carol of the Bells at the end. Also, I would like to remind you that we've got a really spectacular show coming up for you in the late winter. Mary Poppins is going to be presented here in our East Rockingham High School auditorium on March the 3rd, 4th, 5th, and 6th, and we'll soon have more info on that out in the community. Also, these are hard things to do, but necessary things to do. You know, I know that you parents out there and your seniors are thinking, well, you know, this is their last holiday performance. It's certainly not their last performance, but it's their last holiday winter concert. And so, seniors back there, would you please raise your hands and let us thank you appropriately for all of your years. As we get ready to sing our last song, Carol the Bells, on behalf of our choir family, here at East Rock, our administration, our faculty and staff, we want to wish you blessings for a wonderful holiday full of peace and unity and harmony.